major pork company ordered to pay more than $400 million, all in a nuisance lawsuit. And Walmart is testing self-driving grocery carts. Jane King is live at the NASDAQ with those stories and so much more. Good morning, Jane.
Yeah. Good morning. A little bit of a head scratcher, but maybe it makes sense. So we'll have more on that self-driving grocery cart here in a second. But a federal jury did decide that the world's largest pork producer should pay $473 million to neighbors who were bothered by the hog farm operations, smells, and other things. Now, the three Smithfield Foods North Carolina farms also caused flies and rumbling trucks, according to the neighbors who filed the lawsuit. Smithfield will have to make the payments to the households affected. Gas prices are back on the rise again. AAA expects gas prices to trend higher and remain unpredictable heading into the final weeks of the summer driving season. The national gas price average right now is $2.87. That's actually up 52 cents from this time last year. And millions of broadband customers in rural areas are paying nearly identical prices for slower service as customers who have access to high-speed fiber. A report published in the National Digital Inclusion Alliance says in places where AT&T and Verizon don't offer their high-speed fiber-based broadband, they continue to sell customers slower DSL service, but they are not charging any less for that. And Miss America's finances are in question. The Wall Street Journal says girls are flocking to youth sports, also like YouTube. American Idol is there trying to seek fame. And television viewership was 5.4 million last year. That was down 70% from 1997, according to Nielsen. Starbucks says despite recent stories about their involvement in some sort of blockchain project, they're not going to be accepting Bitcoin as a form of payment for coffee. The coffee chain is working with Microsoft and some other companies to create a system for digital assets like Bitcoin, but the venture does not mean you can use digital coins to buy coffee, at least not yet. And Walmart is testing automated grocery carts to speed up delivery. The carts will speed up the process of packaging online orders to send out or bring customers to their, they'll bring these to the customer's car. So the workers will still handpick the produce, meat, and other fresh products, but the automated carts will go up and down the aisles and get the items. Stocks did rise on Friday after the government reported a jobs report that at least the headline number was short of what was expected, but traders just kind of brushed it off as a one-time thing and bought up the markets. And those look like we'll open about 30 points lower today, though. Live from the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Jane King for Fox 8 News. Melissa, back to you.
Jane, thanks so much.
Okay.
Coming up.